Previously on Hotel Babylon.
I've got a rebelling workforce to feed and 4 hours till bloody Christmas.
Take a liberty of swiping one of Gino's finest cognacs.
I would like to propose a toast to Rebecca.
You're probably the closest thing I've got to a really good friend right now.
I'd actually quite like to be friends with me.
Cheers.
Oh, it's not a crack in the end. It's just a question of being in the right spot. The situation's changed. People can surprise you.
We see all sorts of luggage in a hotel. Some people pack the kitchen sink. Some people have got travelling light down to a fine art. And some people don't see the need for luggage at all. But hotels are also full of people carrying a different kind of baggage, the sort you can't easily store under a bed.
And if you think that toupee is fooling anyone, you're wrong.
The marriage that's gone sour. The childhood dreams that never came true. But fortunately, staff are always at hand.
Call that a musical? Girls, half naked, flaunting themselves. It was virtually pornographic.
Well, I can only apologise, sir. Ordinarily, Chicago is a very popular choice.
Absolutely disgusting.
Putting their own woes aside in order to help with yours. Although some days, it's more difficult than others. Maybe we're missing our family. Or we might wish they could know us a little better.
Mum, when I get a girlfriend, you'll be the first to know.
We could be worried. Last night's partying has taken a toll on our looks. Sometimes we're torn between our head and our heart. And of course, there's always that old green-eyed monster, jealousy. But then there are days when we just feel good.
How you doing?
Full of hope.
Morning.
Excited by the prospect of a new romance, maybe.
Morning.
We have absolutely no idea our world is about to come crashing down around our ears.
I just wanted to say that I had a really good time last night.
Yeah, me too.
But I think you'll agree we'd had too much brandy and it probably wasn't a good idea. I mean, if things were different, I mean, if we weren't, then I would probably want to...
Kiss me again?
Yes. But under the circumstances, I think we should probably be sensible.
Yeah, I think you're right, we probably should.
Then again, being sensible can be quite boring.
That is true.
And not everyone can be sensible all the time, can they?
Definitely not.
Sod it. Ah, morning, Jackie.
Hi.
Are the others on their way? Ah, oh, here they are. Morning, everyone. Come
morning.
In.
Morning.
Well, I hope you all had a good time at the party last night.
Weren't you two? Missed out on Gino's spectacular folk dancing.
We decided to just get stuck into the washing up early, didn't we? We didn't want a group of grumpy old porters this morning.
Well, I had a good time last night, but today my enjoyment is spoiled because somebody stole a bottle of my 1796 Napoleon Cognac.
Give it a rest, Gino. It's a Christmas party season of good cheer and all of that.
Well, and pilfering's a tradition.
Well, I can't say I'm happy about it either. The cellar is looking worryingly low, particularly on fine wine.
Well, I'm sorry, Rebecca. I've talked to accounts. They still haven't paid three of my suppliers.
Ah, well, I did get a call this morning from Mrs. Klein, which might just help us out.
Ooh, we hear that, James, a call from Mrs. Klein. She might help you out.
Oh, don't be so juvenile. I admire her knowledge of wine. Nothing more.
Yes. So, why are you turning red?
That's because he's thinking about getting his hands on her Chateauneuf-du-Pape.
Stop it.
Anyway, James, she told me she's decided to sell off some of her late husband's exceptional wine collection, and she's open to offers on a case of Petrus 82.
Good God, that is a rarity.
Exactly. And as she's impressed by your having won the Inter-Hotel Wine Tasting Championship, I'm hoping she'll be inclined to sell it off. Anyway, James, I think you should wine and dine Mrs. Klein. Make her look favourably on our offer. Why don't you ask her for lunch here today?
Good.
Right, well, I'm sure we're all very tired, as the party was very late last night, so that's it for today, thanks.
Thank you.
Apart from Charlie, could you hang on a minute? I just would like a quick word.
Hey, slow down, Chim. How about hearing the dog for our hangovers?
No, after last night, no more freebies, eh?
What, so because of some sticky-fingered cheapskate we all have to suffer?
Look, my customers love that brandy, eh? Now, my profits will be down. And if my profits are down, there's no bonus for me, eh?
But, Gino, we all scratch each other's backs here. Mess with the system and people will get angry.
Let them. I don't get to fix. No.
You don't think Jackie said anything, do you? I mean, she definitely saw something last night.
I don't think so. She's usually pretty discreet.
Yeah, but still, I don't think it would be good if people knew about this.
What exactly is this?
Well, I think it'd be a shame if we didn't,
Do it again.
I guess there'd be no harm in seeing how things go. Unless you don't...
No, absolutely. I take it you're not concerned about being sensible anymore.
Charlie, I always do the sensible thing. My marriage was sensible. Right time, right place. My parents loved him, and look where that got me. Why don't we have dinner tonight?
Yeah, sounds great. As long as you're not cooking.
Oh, cheeky.
And charming with it. I'll see you later.
See ya.
See when my big brother works. You all right?
You're doing all right. You seem a little bit edgy.
Yeah, I'm fine. Actually, I did want to ask you a favour. I need somewhere to stay.
Well, you can stay at mine if you want.
I was thinking you might want me up here. Just need to be out of the way for a little bit. Is there anything dodgy, if that's what you think? Me and my mate, John, have been setting up a business and borrowed some money off these mates.
These mates want the money back and you haven't got it?
Well, yeah.
I can't hide you in a hotel.
John's calling in some favours. He'll get the money dead soon. It'll only be for a couple of days.
Can't do it, mate. I'm a manager here now. I'm sorry, I've got to say no.
Right. I'll just go and get my legs broken while you look after number one, yeah?
Wait.
Room 503 isn't occupied. I checked the Farringtons out an hour ago. No one else has checked in since.
Well, there's a problem with the toilet, so I'm just putting it down as occupied.
The Farringtons didn't mention anything, nor has anyone else.
Well, I'm mentioning it. James may tell Jackie, Jackie's told me. I'm telling you. So avoid booking anyone in 503, okay?
How's
your
desk?
It's only the two geezers to your left sitting in the sofa. I don't like the look of them. Check them out for me, will you, please?
Are you waiting for a guest, sir? Who's asleep?
The name is Neville Bellingham Thomas. I have a reservation. Will you excuse me just for a moment?
Neville!
What a surprise. I didn't know you were coming to London.
Well, some business came up, and as I was visiting, I thought, high time I saw your little piece of England.
Well, it's recently been refurbished. I'm sure you'll agree. It's rather special.
Yes, it's certainly very, de rigueur. Although the old money we cater for at Le Roi Soleil expects something slightly less loud.
So, I don't suppose this business you mentioned would have anything to do with a certain Petrus 82.
Well, I doubt there's a wine buyer in Europe who'd let that little opportunity pass them by.
I think it's only fair to warn you, Mrs. Klein and I go back years. Mm. No, she was rather impressed with my winning the Inter-Hotel Wine Tasting Championships.
Oh, good God, James, you're not still banging on about that old triumph, are you? And just because you have a crush on Mrs. Klein, don't assume it's mutual.
Oh, I do not have a crush.
Anyway, I must call my truffle supplier. I'll be back at lunchtime.
Yes. I'm sorry. Are you dining here?
Yes, with Mrs. Klein. When you invited her to lunch, she kindly asked me to join her. So I wouldn't be so sure you'll get that Petrus after all.
All right. I could get used to this, no worries.
Yeah, well, don't get too comfortable. No regular minibar, no going on walkabouts. If anybody asks you what you're doing in here...
Yeah, I don't know. I'm here to fix a satellite telly. You think I'm stupid?
Listen, there's a couple of extras from The Godfather knocking about in the lobby. No one knows you're here, do they?
No. No, I never told anyone I was coming. Thought we could get a couple of drinks later.
I can't. I've got to go out for some dinner.
Right.
Well, maybe we can catch a quick one. We'll see.
Cool.
I'll see you later.
See you later.
It's Mrs. Ballinger. Don't ask him.
I was just actually going to come and find you. I wanted to speak to you about last night. I'd be really grateful if you didn't say anything. And if anyone wants to find out, I'll...
Don't worry, I won't tell anybody.
Thanks, Jackie.
So are you two going to keep seeing each other?
Oh, no. We've just had a few too many brandies. And I think we're both feeling a bit...
Right. Sorry, I know how you feel about relationships at work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I better get back.
Yeah, me too. I'll catch you later.
And make sure you rake the gravel. The drive is a disgrace.
Mrs. Klein, how wonderful to see you. And looking so well.
I hate it when people say I'm looking well. Makes me think I've been looking ill.
No, I certainly didn't mean to imply.
You can go now. Be back at 3 and don't be late.
Come this way.
I believe you two know each other.
Oh, yes. We trained together at Le Roi Soleil.
James came back to England when I was offered the permanent post.
Well, we couldn't all sleep with the manager, now could we, Neville?
At least I was sleeping with someone.
Now, gentlemen. I'm hungry. Show us our table, James.
Just here.
And bring me a bottle of Margot 95.
And do be quick, I'm parched.
Yeah, I think for me, my wedding dance has to be Hello, by Lionel Richie. And my romantic. God willing, I get married, eh?
Gino! Would you get me a bottle of Margot 95? I'm rushed off my feet here. Please?
No problem.
Excuse me, sir. Could you tell me where I might find Charlie Edwards?
That's him coming out of the lift, sir.
Mr. Edwards, I'm Detective Sergeant Green. This is my colleague, D.C. Porter. Can we have a word?
Of course, let's go into the office.
It's all right. Why don't we just sit in the bar?
Okay. Can I get you coffee?
Actually, I've always wanted to try one of them fancy cocktails. Non-alcoholic, Porter. Keep your air on.
Anybody there?
I haven't spoken to Danny months. We're not that close. Is he in some kind of trouble?
A friend of his, Mr. John Sampson, is in hospital in a coma. Seems someone wasn't very happy with him. What do you call these?
They're Japanese rice crackers.
Mm. They're delicious. You should see the grub at the station. It's a health hazard.
Your brother went to art school, didn't he?
Well, if you can call dropping out after 6 weeks going to art school, then yeah. Why do you want to know?
It seems Mr. Sampson had a nice little earner going running a forgery racket. He was arranging the sales, and we think it was your brother playing at being Leonardo.
We're hoping Dan might know who'd want to do this to Mr. Sampson.
Any idea where he'd go? Girlfriend, perhaps?
No idea. Like I said, I'm not that close.
Yes, you did say, didn't you? Although you'd be amazed how many family members don't remember each other when we start asking questions.
Anyway, we'll let you get on with your work. But, here's my card. Should you hear from your brother, let us know.
Mm. Mm. You don't mind if I take a few of these with me, do you?
Be my guest.
Tuck.
It isn't appropriate, is it?
I hope you both enjoyed your meals.
Yes, it was very pleasant. The steak's always very tricky. I think only French kitchens really know how to get it rare enough.
Yeah, looks pretty rare to me, Neville. In fact, if it was any rarer, I'd be mooing and eating grass.
This wine is excellent. It has both the intensity of the 86 and the wonderful ripeness of the 90.
Yes, it was a very good vintage. But then you've always had impeccable taste, Mrs. Klein.
Absolutely. I was just about to say the same myself.
Mm. Yes, but I said it first.
Well, you've never been backwards and coming forwards, have you, Neville? Numerous waiters at Loire Soleil would vouch for that.
Oh, for goodness sake, stop squabbling. I know you're both after the Petrus. You're so desperate for it, I've come up with an amusing plan. I'm going to have you compete for it.
Compete?
Tomorrow morning I'll be bringing some fine wines, and the person who gets closest to guessing what they are will win a chance to buy the Petrus.
That's a very amusing idea, and I for one relish the challenge. And I do think it's time James proved his mettle once more.
I'd be happy to.
Did you tell Charlie that there's a problem with the loo in room 503?
No, why?
It's just that he told me that you told him that there's a problem.
Maybe he misheard him.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. See, I suspect that he got off with someone last night and he wants to use the room for an illicit rendezvous. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you. It's just that I presume that you've moved on.
I have. I'm not upset. I just don't think what Charlie gets up to should be anyone else's business.
No, of course. Oops. Charlie, can I have a word?
Sorry, I can't. I've got a nip upstairs for a meeting.
Sure. What, I was starving? No one saw me.
Well, I knew they were angry, but I didn't think they'd try and kill him.
Police also said something about a forgery racket. What's all that about? No bullshit this time.
All right, look. I only ever wanted it to be small time. But John met this rich bloke, convinced him he had an original Mondrian.
Bloke found out he was moody and now he wants his money back.
I am going to sort out somewhere else to go. I just need one night here, two tops. Please, Charlie.
Come on, I need to get you back to your room.
Anna told me there was a problem in here. I just came to have a look. You're Charlie's brother. I've seen family snaps.
Dan, this is Jackie. Dan's in London for a couple of days. I just thought it'd be easier to put him up here. You're not going to say anything, are you?
Of course not. What's the point in working at a hotel if you can't get the odd freebie, right?
Thanks, Jackie. I appreciate it.
You might want to talk to Anna. I think she suspects you want the room for something.
Five O 3 is on the fifth floor. You come over the lift, turn left, and it's a few doors down on your right.
Thank you. My God, it's only Bernard Short, Bernie, you old bastard.
I told you there was a problem with 503.
Yeah, and Jackie said that there isn't. The Franks are two of our richest regulars, and they requested a Royal Parkview room. Now, 503 is the only one we've got available. I didn't want to deprive them just because you want to indulge in some afternoon delight or whatever it is that you're up to. Of course, we can always go and ask Rebecca.
No, that's fine.
Hmm.
Hello.
get you out of here.
Hey,
some gas on the way home.
I thought you had that covered.
So did I. Yeah, help me tidy the bed, will you? Excellent.
Yeah.
Just leave this along, get your stuff together.
You okay?
Absolutely, yeah. Fine.
I was just wondering what those detectives wanted earlier.
Oh, I witnessed a fight near my flat and, they just neighbours barney. They want me to confirm your statement, that's all.
Right, well, as long as you haven't been getting up to no good. Unless it's with me, of course. I've been dying to do this all morning. Charlie, are you okay? You seem a bit distracted.
No, I'm absolutely fine. I'm just slightly concerned about someone coming in, that's all.
Well, I guess I'll just have to control myself until tonight, then.
Listen, about tonight, I'm not going to be able to make dinner.
Right, okay. Right, well, that's probably for the best anyway. I've got lots of paperwork to do, and, listen, I think I better get on.
I'd love nothing more than to spend the evening with you. But I'm going to have to be out of here by 6. A mate of mine is moving and I promised him that I'd help him, that's all. I can sort something out for tomorrow night, though.
Yeah, I think I can do tomorrow.
I'll find somewhere extra special.
Great. I'll see you later.
Who is that? Not now. Here, lock yourself in. I'll be back in a bit.
All right, Gina.
Everything
okay?
Look. Oh, Gina, you could do the tidying up a bit.
No. I didn't do this mess. Somebody turned the picture of my parents upside down. I don't know. Something strange is going on earlier in the cellar. I hear piano music. Nobody was there. I know this. What is it?
Oh, nothing. It's a bit strange, that's all.
Well, there's probably some logical explanation for it, you know, somebody banged the lockers or something like that. See you later.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Oh, the ghost?
Yeah.
There's a concierge who died here in the 30s. He was big on staff being good to each other. They say when a staff member's angry with his co-workers, it unsettles his spirit.
Anna's got some guests in 503. You don't know if there are any other rooms vacant in the hotel, do you?
314? Do you want me to tell Anna if there's a fault in the room?
Oh, I'd love it if you could. I'd owe you one.
You could always make me one of your famous lasagnas. I've been missing them.
Well, they are rather special, even if I say so myself.
Are you wearing a new aftershave? So good.
Thanks. Anyway, I'd better get back. I have a brother hiding in the storeroom.
Yeah.
I've come to say sorry for taking the piss earlier. It wasn't very fair of us.
Get it. I've got bigger things to worry about.
Come on, if you won that hotel championship, you'll walk this.
Well, if I had actually have won, then maybe I would. I cheated. There it is. My sordid admission. I have a terrible nose. This is about the only wine I can ever guess. My trusty friend in hours of need, the Latour 90. Oh, well, by this time tomorrow, everybody will know I'm a fraud.
You don't know for certain you'll lose.
I do love a Californian Merlot. 1990 was such a good year.
That's so good.
That has got to be a fluke.
Give me that. Try that.
Okay. Well, it tastes like a Cab Franc, but not quite. Which probably makes it a Cab... French? 95?
How did you do that?
Well, I'm always drinking fine wines left in a restaurant. I must have picked up a thing or two.
Great. Things are going from bad to worse. Now I feel like Salieri with Mozart.
Right. Well, it might not be all bad. Won't you need someone to pull for you tomorrow?
I thought you were going at 6.
I was, yeah. My friend phoned and something's come up, so well, he's not moving tonight.
Right, well, you should have said, because we could still...
I'm going to go over there anyway, just to help him pack.
Oh.
I said I'd get something for Bobby's security.
Sorry, it just came on the radio, I didn't think. Sorry.
I brought you a bit of food.
Thank you. Sorry about messing up your date with that woman.
It's coming then.
Who is she?
The mystery babe. Her name's Rebecca. She's my boss.
You are joking. It might be a bit tricky, shagging a one person at Casato.
Well, it is at the moment, yeah. Having to lie to her every 2 minutes because you're here.
Yeah, that's sort of what I mean.
This is a first for you, innit? Wanting to engage in a sensible conversation.
Yeah, you're right. I'm far too sober. Let's do the minibar in.
All right, well, I'm not getting pissed. It's a school night.
Yeah, Charlie.
I've been dying to do this all morning.
Nothing changes. Still cramping my style.
Oh, when have I ever...
Right, it's bedtime.
Some of us have got work to do in the morning. You can stay on the floor. No way. Well, plenty of room for two.
There you are. I think you know Detectives Green and Porter. They want to talk to you about your brother. Right, well, I'll leave you to it. I've got a few things to do.
Don't mind if I eat while we talk, do you?
Please.
These eggs with mayo are great. You don't get them down a greasy spoon.
Can we, I'm sorry, I've just got a lot of words.
Oh, yeah, I'm forgetting. You're a busy man. Well, we were just wondering if you'd had any more thoughts about where Dan might be.
Well, I've already told you, I've got no idea.
It's just we found some evidence at the crime scene that indicates your brother tried to kill John Sampson.
What evidence?
We're not at liberty to say.
No, of course you're not. I don't think you've got any. And I can tell you now, my brother's not a violent man.
Well, obviously, the quickest way to find out if we're wrong would be to speak to him.
And he got on a train for London 2 days ago.
Well, London's a big place, isn't it?
True, it's just... If I needed somewhere to hide... I'd probably try a place like this. Nice and big. Plenty of space to get lost in.
If my brother was in any sort of trouble, I'd be the last person he'd come and see.
Well, we'll just have to take your word for that. For now.
Well, is there anything else?
Oh, no, you go ahead. We're just going to finish off here.
Sorry about that.
Why didn't you tell me they were looking for your brother?
Well, he's a bit of a liability, and I just didn't want to get into it.
The police think that he might be hiding here. They are wrong, Charlie, aren't they?
Yeah, I haven't spoken to Dan in weeks.
You sure?
Absolutely, I won't do something like that.
Oh, you must be really worried.
Well, I'm just trying not to think about it. Anyway, I better get off. I've got to speak to Tony about his hours this week.
Okay, but why don't you tell me about it tonight?
We'd like to know about your family.
Sure. I'll catch you later.
Where does that wine come from?
Italy.
No. My ear is Italian, my nose is French. Okay, remember this?
Chile.
Australian.
Oh, sod it. Which is hardly going to bring wine from a country where everybody's grandfather is a convict.
Okay, you need to stay calm.
How can I? Well, I can't remember that your ear's Italian, your nose is French.
Well, you obviously do, because you just told me.
Oh, you know what you need? Gino, any chance of a brandy for James?
He'll pay.
Have to go down to the cellar.
We're obviously trying to set me up. Oh, come on, you don't seriously think I did it, do you? Look, this isn't my fault, it wasn't even my...
Enough! You spent the last 10 years of your life pissing around with shitty little scams that always end up going on their ass, expecting me to bail you out. Well, I'm not going to this time. If they want you for murder, that makes me an accessory, and there is no way on earth that I'm going back inside.
Look, I've got a plan. Mate of mine manages a shop in Prague. If I can get over there, he'll sort me out. All I need is a passport.
Forget it, not a chance.
Oh, come on, Charlie, you must know somebody who can sort that out.
No! You're on your own. I'm not getting my hands any dirtier than they already are. I want you out of the hotel.
Oh, please, come back inside. Let's talk.
There's nothing to say.
Is this because you think I did it?
Well, did you?
Jesus, Charlie, no! Is that how little you think of me, that I try and kill my own mate? Might not be some big success like you, but I'm not some sick bastard. They're going to kill me, Charlie. Is that what you want? I don't know, you might think that I deserve it, but you better be sure, because it's you that's got to live with yourself when I'm dead.
Thank you. I didn't say I was going to do anything. So think about it.
Hello? Who's there? Hello? Who is it? Come out! Yeah, fine. Just trip over.
Excuse me, we're just asking the staff a few questions. Would you mind if we had a word?
Sorry, what's it about?
Why don't we find somewhere to sit?
Okay.
Tony. I think the ghost of the concierge is haunting me. Must be because I didn't give you those freebies. I was just in the cellar. Heard music. I mean, laughter, like a man possessed. And then, I saw 2 or 7 written on the floor. In blood.
Concierge don't have a heart attack in 2 weeks, so...
What should I do?
I don't know, like... There was a waiter who did a rather smart thing.
What was that, Demi?
Well, he went up to 207. And he apologised for pissing off a porter.
Did the ghost go away afterwards?
Well, I think so. Look, it's got to be worth a try.
Definitely, definitely.
Come along. Angus, don't dawdle. I hope you're both fighting fit and ready for battle.
Absolutely. I imagine you must be feeling a tad nervous, Jen.
Not at all, Neville. I'm rather looking forward to wiping the floor with you.
Well, we'll see about that.
Yes, we will.
Quite.
Yes.
Good.
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 The manager's kindly lent us her office.
Yes.
Why don't we wait in the bar while Ben sets the room up for us?
I think I'd prefer if Angus did it. I don't want anything getting broken.
No. I mean... No, the general manager would be happier if it was one of our staff, because... there's a lot of confidential information in there.
All right, then, but be quick about it.
Okay. Let's go to the bar, shall we?
You see her, then you just give her a ring, and I will leave her card at reception.
Don't worry, I didn't tell him anything.
Thank you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I lied to you. I just didn't want to inform you.
It's okay, I understand.
He hasn't done it, Jackie. There's no way that I'd protect him if he'd hurt someone.
Are you okay? I'm really worried about you.
need to tell me what I can do to help.
It's me, Gino Primarola. I want to say that I'm very, very sorry for not giving free drinks to Tony and Anna. It was very unfair of me, but at least they brought Tony and Anna together, which will make Anna very happy. Anna, she always saying to me, Gino, Tony is a hot guy. I want him very much. Anyways, I'm going now. And of course, I will give free drinks to all my friends. So please, please, leave me alone.
I don't know where he got that idea from, because that's just absolute rubbish.
Anna? It's fine. I'm actually quite flattered.
Tony, there is nothing to be flattered about because I just don't fancy you.
Charlie Edwards.
Yes, I'm Harvey.
My name is David. This is my colleague Mike. Your brother's been doing some business with our boss. In my office. No, that's fine. We won't be staying long. We were just wondering if you knew where Dan is.
Well, no, I haven't seen him in months.
It's just he owes our boss a lot of money, and he's understandably unhappy about it. So is Mike. Mike has anger management problems, and in spite of all of our best efforts, he sometimes loses control.
Well, I'd love to help you, but I can't. Like I say, I haven't seen him in months, and I'm pretty busy, so if you'll excuse me.
If you do happen to see Dan, could you give him a message from us? Tell him if he doesn't pay back what he owes, we'll find him. And Mike will cut short his artistic career by smashing his hands to pulp.
Right, Johnny?
Everything's fine. He was just leaving.
You okay?
No, yeah, I think the old Bill will watch you.
I'm guessing this is about your brother. Police were asking questions.
I need to get my passport. And I don't know anyone in that game.
They say a good concierge can get you anything. You didn't hear it from me. My name's Karen. You mention my name, she should be able to sort you out.
Thanks, Tom.
You're welcome. Be careful, Charlie. You don't want to go down for this.
Let's get started then. You know the rules. I want grape variety, country, region, and vintage. Whoever gets the most things right wins.
To taste wine blind is a difficult art. You need to use all of your senses, your nose, your taste buds, and even your eyes. Great powers of description come in handy.
It has a wonderful chocolatey aroma. It reminds me of a chocolaterie that I often visit in Aix-en-Provence.
I'm pretty sure this is a 1990.
An excellent memory for dates is a must.
Four.
A touch of pretentiousness is almost a requirement.
The tart quality must make it 92. It was an exceptionally bad year for Pinot in Burgundy.
I would say this was,
And you're lost without an expansive knowledge of wine-growing countries.
Italian? I'd say it was definitely Italian.
You're absolutely right, James. Well, gentlemen, we have a tie. And, fortunately, I brought this with me for just such an eventuality. Ben, could you give James and Neville a pen and paper? Angus, could you pour them both some wine, please? Say it's Bulgari, probably 2001.
Oh, yes.
And James, you say it's Bordeaux, a Latour 90.
Yes.
Well, gentlemen, we have a winner. James, the Petrus is yours.
Yes! Well, Neville, I think I've proved my mettle. Don't you?
Oh, Tony.
Yeah.
Have you seen Charlie anyway?
Upstairs, I think.
I've had Mr. Ainsley on the phone twice. Charlie's meant to be dealing with his wedding plans.
What?
If you do see him, could you tell him I'm looking for him, please?
Absolutely.
Thank you. Get in. Well, when you said you worked with Tony, I was expecting some spotty-faced water.
I really can't hang around.
No. I don't imagine you can. I was just curious, that's all.
There's the money, it's all right. You can count it if you want.
No, on second thoughts, maybe you should just owe me. Working in a place like this, you're bound to come in handy someday.
I'd rather not. I'm out of that game, thanks.
Don't mean to be funny, but looks like you're back in it to me. Where have you been? Mr. Ainsley's called twice. I've been looking everywhere for you.
There's been an argument down in the kitchen, so I had to go and sort it out.
I went in the kitchen. I didn't see you.
Or maybe we just missed each other.
Maybe. Charlie, who were those men you were talking to earlier?
Some friends. Just popped in to say hello.
They didn't look very friendly. Charlie, you know, if I ever found something out, something that might compromise me as manager of this hotel, no matter how close I was to that person, I would have to put the hotel first.
No, no, you would.
Listen, about dinner tonight.
Are you thinking that maybe we've been maybe a little bit hasty?
So are we saying that we're going to do the sensible thing after all?
I guess I am, yeah.
Well, I've got a meeting to go to. Take care of yourself, Charlie.
Did you get it? Thank you, mate. Thank you. Search the premises.
A little bit of money to help you when you get there.
You don't have to do that.
Take it. Just promise me you'll make a fresh start.
Trust me. I learned my lesson. Never going to get involved in anything like that ever again. So I guess this is hasta la vista time.
I guess it is.
Give us a shout next time you're in Prague, yeah?
I might just do that.
Let me know how it's going with your boss. She's fit. She go for it.
Sure.
They're here. We have to go now.
Thank you.
Tony, can I say that you're looking very dapper today? Wouldn't you say, Anna?
I can't say that I've noticed, no.
Oh, I think you will like this new recipe.
Well, that's more like it.
Cheers, Gina.
Cheers.
Oh. What the hell is that?
It's disgusting.
It's called Two Naughty People Hiding in the Wardrobe.
Oh. Come in.
Here it is. One case of Petrus 82, as promised.
Oh, that's wonderful, James. Well done. I'm so pleased.
I can't take all the credit. Ben was there, cheering me on. All right. You don't mind me saying so. You look a little out of sorts.
No, I'm fine. I just had a little something in my eye, that's all. Well, thanks again, James. You've done me proud.
We work long hours in a hotel. Our co-workers can become like family. And of course, we do all the things families do. We tease each other.
What about all the lights flickering and the laughter in the cellar?
Yeah, it's amazing what you can do with a fuse box and a download off the net, Gina.
I just can't believe that you thought that I fancied you.
Yeah, right.
But we generally forgive each other. We help each other out when we're in a tight spot.
Thank you again. I'm sorry it's not a Petrus 82, but that would have cost me £3,500 a bottle.
Oh, thank you. This is great.
I'm off home, but well done again, James. I always admire a man who can rise to the challenge.
We enjoy each other's triumphs.
Neville?
We watch each other's backs.
It's okay, it all went smoothly, so you don't have to worry.
Thanks, Jackie. You're a diamond.
Don't mention it. I'm sure you would have done the same for me.
Even if our relationships are complicated.
Did you get everything you needed?
Thanks to you. How are you, mate?
Yeah, you're done.
And of course, we also hurt each other.
Your phone?
Yeah.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow, then.
See you tomorrow.
Even when we don't mean to.
What's going on?
Is that God?
More important than God, that is Donovan Credo.
Once your people have fixed a purchase price,
Hotel Babylon will cease to exist.
Jesus.
You better tell Rebecca to do something about it before all hell breaks loose. Enough!
We have to make the hardest choice a manager can make, sacking people.
We have to start somewhere.
Oh, so says the white man sitting on the boss's side of the table.
I think we should take this little chat as effective notice of my resignation.
We are good workers. We are good people, eh?
Hold my hand.
This place is my life.
I never really miss working with you.
Are you going to tell me what I'm asking here, or am I going to go and clear my locker?
Making your Good Friday even better, the coolest cops are back on the block as Ben Stiller and Owen Wilson star in the network premiere of Starsky and Hutch tomorrow at 9 here on BBC One.